On y va. We're going to do a terrine of foie gras. So, what is foie gras? Foie gras is duck liver. If you translate, will be fat liver. Their liver are very big and very fatty. It's almost like yellow because it's so much fat. In French cuisine, foie gras is a very delicacy. Okay, we eat a lot of foie gras, but especially for holidays or when you go to a restaurant. Okay, don't think like all the mother or the grandma they do terrine of foie gras every day at home. No. Okay, it's something still a lot of people don't know how to do a terrine of foie gras. First, you need to clean the foie gras. Make sure your foie gras is room temp, almost like a soft butter. It's more easy to clean. So you see, I'm spread a little bit of foie gras like this. It's a little bit like when you watch a CSI, you know, when you do an autopsy. I know, great, sorry. It's funny because I'm not really an awful guy. I don't like to eat too much like brain or whatever. But foie gras is good. Do you see the vein in there? That's what we're going to take up. Look at this. Let's just follow the vein with my little spoon. So just throw like this my vein, et voilà. What? Ça, we don't eat, hein? You take up all the little vein in the foie. So I'm going to put back the foie gras like the way it was, okay? But trust me, when you work in the French cuisine, you do a lot of foie gras. It's really a legacy, hein? No holidays with no foie gras. Foie gras is like a diamond, you know, in cooking. And I'm going to flat all our lobe of foie gras, okay, on our sheet, like this. So I'm putting my salt here, the salt everywhere, comme ça. Okay, not just one touch in the middle, pepper, a little bit. A little bit cognac. If you don't want cognac, don't put cognac, hein. It's okay, if you don't want any alcohol, it's fine. They give a little bit of acidity. Good lemon zest everywhere. So we're going to do both sides. Okay, it's like when you're seasoning a steak, you're seasoning the foie gras both sides. Voilà. So now your foie gras is ready to cook. We have a nice terrine, okay? Best terrine, seriously. Take this one from France, Le Creuset. That's a really the best terrine. You buy that, you have it for the rest of your life. Trust me, you can do everything with that. So we don't want the terrine to be too fatty. So we're going to press it to take up all the fat. And we're going to have just the meat left. So for press it, so on a little carton, voilà comme ça. You wrap it like this. Okay guys, voilà. Voilà, I prepare my how you say that again?
Cardboard
for press the foie gras. Hein? Okay, voilà. Now we're going to put the foie gras in the terrine like this. So we keep the lobe intact. I'm going to see some beautiful layer when we cut it. Put again here. Okay, like this. Thank you. Put the foie gras here. Ta-da! And we're going to go to the oven, okay? We're going to go on 350. Voilà. Now I'm going to show you how to do a little condiment to go with the foie gras. Hein? We're going to peel our date. The easy way, we're going to blanch the date and it'll be so easy to take up the skin. So just to bring to boil a little bit. Voilà. So now we're going to peel the date. So easy to peel, so easy. And I'm going to take up the seed. Et voilà. We have my date here. I'm going to add a little bit salted butter in my mix. And I'm just going to match like this. It could become like a paste, like a puree. Voilà. Good. Now we're going to put it in the fridge, okay? Okay, so mix very well just before. I'm going to put that for at least, you know, a good hour. Voilà. Et voilà. Une petite bouteille de Pellegrino, moi. Et voilà, guys. Okay, foie is ready. But here. Voilà. Ta-da! So you see all the foie gras fat? So let's go, guys. Let me show you something. So now, we're going to cool down the foie gras quick. So I'm moving my terrine here. Okay, and here I'm going to put cold water, okay? So my water is cold. So I'm putting back my foie gras here. Now I'm going to add my little
cardboard.
I still cannot remember the name of this cardboard. Here like this. And now we're going to press it. Là, et là, and we press. The fat go away, look guys. You can always reuse the fat if you want. It's a good fat also to sear a piece of chicken, sear a piece of steak. Now we're going to put the whole thing in the fridge. It's very, it's a real operation that, you know, if you don't know, it's very complicated. I mean, that's very technical, as you can see. It takes very long time. We press the foie gras, say, for like two hours in the fridge. Overnight is better, definitely. Huh? So we're going to take up the weight now. Voilà. Then now, I'm going to take the fat. See, so the fat is a little cold here. Voilà. So now we're going to take up our cardboard. So I'm going to melt a little bit the fat here. So now we're going to put it back here on the top of the foie gras. Everywhere like this. It's going to be a protection from oxidation. And now we're going to put back that in the fridge. And let it for overnight, you know, until it's very, very cold, okay? Bye-bye, foie gras terrine. The magic of Ludo House. Our terrine is set. See, guys? Voilà, the fat, it's hard. It's time to slice. It's time to eat. I'm just going to slice here slowly. Ah. Voilà, I'm going to put a little bit of our date condiment here. Salt here. Black pepper here. Voilà. So this is our foie gras terrine. So I'll try a little bit of a foie gras like this. Put a little bit of salt, condiment of that date. Mmm. Pretty good with salty, so it's perfect with the foie. I don't feel like drinking alcohol sometimes, sorry guys. That's the way you do it, guys. You know, you want to do a good terrine of foie gras for your holidays. Trust me, you're going to have a beautiful, amazing holidays with foie gras terrine. Trust me.